So it all started on September 15th. Decided that I wanted to, you know, try something different, explore new things for the Allies, and came across the idea of going to Rainbow's house to make shit a little bit more interesting. So I decided to shoot him a DM, asking him, you know, if it would be okay for me to just record and us hang out and shit and see how things go. And he said no. That caught me off guard, so I tried to think outside the box. I sent Rainbow a DM, you know, just being a little bit more clever about it to see if it worked. And I didn't think it'd work. I thought, you know, like, okay, this nigga said no. So the answer is no. I was in awe. This nigga immediately sent me back his full address. He had the Google Map link in there too. And he finalized it all with the smiley emoji and a black thumbs up. So we were in there. I decided to collect all my gear, get the camera, and I was off. Clicked the Google Maps link and decided to make my way to Rainbow's house. It was extraordinary. All up until the point where got caught up at a crossroad and I found out that the street that I had to turn on, it was beaten up, run down, fucked up. It was insane. It was incredible. This nigga's street was filled with druggies, gangsters. I saw fucking Crips and Bloods throwing gang signs at each other and shit. And I'm just standing there on the street with this fucking Bob the Builder outfit. You know, I had my hammer, had the camera and shit. Tim's with the steel toe, looking like Steve Urkel with my blue light glasses and shit. Yang cap looked like some construction worker types of stuff. I came right out of the fucking Sesame Street episode. You know, I was completely unsure. Like, I was like, oh shit, did I follow Google Maps correctly? Took another glance at it, and sure enough, yeah, I was in the right place. Motherfucker was living on some 6th and 7th Street type of shit. You know, that type of street where your parents would be like, nope, mijo, don't go there. Nigga was living in the projects. The definition of ghetto. You open up the definition of ghetto and you saw just Rainbow Street pop up. I progressed, I walked forward and got up to Rainbow's doorstep. And I was staring at it and that shit was just, I was in awe. I know I've said that multiple times, but I was. I mean, that shit was beaten the fuck up, broken down, scratched, scraped, chipped. Nigga, the door looked like some shit from Monsters, Inc. I felt like I was in the movie. I was trying to put the puzzle pieces together to have the door activate and work. I couldn't believe that nigga had a door like that. Anybody could have walked up in that bitch and stole anything he had in the house. Well, I wasn't in the house yet, but I would have already assumed everything that was in the house was gone because, nigga, that wasn't a door. That was a walkway. That nigga had me looking on the ground for a couple of scraps and pieces so that I can help put it together all again. Maybe increase the protection rate. I don't fucking know. So, you know, did what anybody would do. I looked for the doorbell, and to my surprise, I saw this post-it note on the doorbell, and it said, please do not push. Now, obviously, the moment you look at that motherfucker's door, you already know the drill. So I obliged, and I knocked on the door instead, gently, of course. Then I got that feeling again of, okay, I need to be sure, like, if this is Rainbow's house, I need to know this is Rainbow's house. So I turned around and I looked to see what was across the street because I remember from Rainbow ran like in the middle of a stream to go to 7-Eleven to grab a bag of Takis. Keep in mind, in the middle of a fucking stream. So I turned around and sure enough, right across the street was a 7-Eleven. And right at that moment, I knew, yep, this has gotta be this nigga's house. Now, as I'm staring at this 7-Eleven, all I hear behind me is this really loud screech. Couldn't even believe that this nigga had never heard of WD-40 before. You know, and as the doors just gradually opening and I can just hear the motherfucking Michael Jackson intro to Thriller popping off. I see at the corner of my eye, across the street, the motherfucking Bloods and Crips. They were about to get into a fucking debacle. They're about to start fighting and shit. But it's as if they had recognized Rainbow's door as just like the door that was so fucked up. It sounded like they recognized the Michael Jackson theme song. And they both looked at each other. They just literally started dancing. Like it was like a TikTok video. It was incredible. The motherfucker's door was bringing together the gangs. They weren't saying, "Subu, I'm in awe." And I turn around and all I see is just a 5'10" bisexual furry African-American male in their late 20s is standing right in front of me. And I'm thinking to myself, oh shit, it's Rainbowfur. I had a little bit of a smirk on my face and I stared at him I didn't say anything. I just stared at him and Rainbow's looking. At first I thought he was looking at me. Like at first he had a disappointed face. Right? His expression was just not too pleased. As I kept looking, I noticed he wasn't looking at me. This nigga was straight up looking behind me. It was odd. His eyes, they weren't making eye contact with me. It was as if this nigga was looking at the Takis. Rainbow, he looked mad. He looked really mad. Or he looked really hungry. I don't know what it was, but we kind of just were just stuck there. You know, my head was just squeezed in between his eyes. I'm just standing there, you know. I was kind of a little bit worried. I didn't know what was going on. We kind of stood there. It felt like it had to be at least a minute, 45 seconds tops. It was kind of getting a little bit weird because he didn't do anything. You know, he was just kind of standing there just looking. And it was as if I was invisible. My head just kind of phased away and shit. And after the 45 seconds to potential minute, it was as if, you know, he finally realized, like, ding, and his eyes clicked to me. It wasn't at the same time. It was the right eye first and then the left eye right after. And then he's like,
oh shit, Terrell, what?
And you know, I'm just standing there like, yeah, nigga, yeah, it's me, what's up? And, you know, he's like, oh, shit, Terrell. And, you know, we were shooting the shit a bit, talking about streams and whatever for a minute, maybe. And I took a glance behind me, and I realized that fucking Bloods and Crips behind me on the sidewalk were done dancing to MJ. Told Rainbow, you know, let me come in or what? And Rainbow just looks at me, he's like,
oh, yeah, I got you.
Opens his door wider and leans to the side of me, he's like, come on in. I'm just kind of like, why are you gonna act as if you're the dude from Big Hero 6 and shit, living in a mansion? And stop acting out, bro. I walk into his house and took like maybe 4 steps, and instantly I came into contact, butted my fucking bridge nose, and I just hit a wall. I was like, what the fuck? Looked up and I saw just this flickering light bulb. It was kind of cracked. Shit was busted. And it's just hanging and dangling on this string and shit. It was like a horror film. Looked to my right and I'm thinking, you know, okay, maybe I gotta walk to the right. Took one step, cause you know, I got big feet and all. Took one step and instantly came into contact with another fucking wall. Butted my fucking bridge. Once again, now I'm confused. I'm looking around, I'm just like, I'm stuck in this fucking cubicle. This nigga's house was a fucking lie. It was literally a fucking cubicle. I just hear the fucking, once again, Michael Jackson, he just magically appears in the fucking house again. I just hear the door closing, MJ's playing, and I turn around and I just see Rainbow. He's right in front of me again, and I'm kind of looking at him. I'm a little bit confused. I'm trying to wonder, okay, you know, is there something else here that I'm missing? I kid you not. I'm staring at him, waiting for the grand tour. I can tell right off the bat. Didn't take me much long to understand this, but Rainbow was doing the same shit again. I'm just right in the middle of his face, and he's looking dead at me, and all he sees is his fucked up wall. Where did Terrell go? It was like that ding moment that happened originally, but this time his left eye hit me first and then his right eye kind of followed suit and came a couple of seconds later. Oh yeah, Terrell, all right, let's go this way. I then see this other hallway in the house. I'm like, oh, okay, well, there we fucking go. I thought he was living in a motherfucking cubicle. We start walking down this hallway. Shit looked like I was already dead. It was like the hallway to heaven. because that room we were in was so dark and the room across was so bright. I couldn't believe it. I was like, all right, let's do this. And we walk, get down the hallway, and my mind is fucking blown to smithereens. I could not believe what I was looking at.